Okay, so we talk about another linear time sorting algorithm, which is radix sort. It's the idea of radix sort was invented by Harman in 1890. Very old sorting algorithm, and it was used for US sensor. So they use a card for this sorting algorithm, US sensor. And the idea of this radix sort is basically digit by digit sort. Digit by digit sort. And the original version of the Hellman was from most significant digit to the least significant digit, but that idea was having some drawback. So, the original version of the radix sort is most significant bit to least significant bit. But that is having some drawback, that idea is not good. So, then it is modified, and the current radix sort is basically least significant to the most significant. So, we sort this number digit by digit by the least significant bit to the radix sort. So, digit by digit sort least significant digit to least significant digit or bit to digit to. So, least significant digit is first, then the we come most significant, least significant digit to most significant digit. Okay. And whether we are sorting this each digit, we will use a help of auxiliary sorting algorithm. These are stable sorting algorithm. So when we sort this each digit, I mean number based on that particular digit, so we will take help of a auxiliary stable sorting algorithm. Maybe we can use the counting sort, stable sorting algorithm. Okay. So, let us take an example, then it will be more clear. So, suppose we have this number 3, 2, 9, 4, 5, 7, 6, 5, 7, these are the input, 8, 3, 9, these are the three digit number. And these are decimal digit, each of these is a decimal number, 3, 8, 3, 9, 4, 3, 6, 7, 2, 0, 3, 5, 5. Okay. So, how many numbers? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So, these are the input, we need to sort these numbers. Okay, so this is basically three bits, and each digit are a decimal digit. Okay, now this is a digit by digit sorting algorithm, and we start with the least significant digit. So this is the least significant digit. So we sort this number based on this value. And we will use a stable sorting algorithm. Say we are taking help of a counting sort, which is a stable sorting algorithm we know, we are taking a linear time stable sorting algorithm. So, we cannot use the comparison based sort, it is not a linear. So, we take help of a stable sorting algorithm, and we sort this number based on this digit. Okay, so 0 will come first, so 7 to 0, then what is the next 5, 3, 5, 5, then we have 6, 4, 3, 6, and then we have 7, but we have 2, 7, and this is a stable sorting algorithm. So, this 7 is appearing first in the input, so this should come first. So, basically we should have 4, 5, 7 and then 6, 5, 7 because of stability. We are using a stable sorting algorithm. And then the next number is 9, again we are using the stability. So, 3 to 9 will come first, then 8, 3, 6. So, this is the sorting after first 7 to 0, 3, 5, 5, 4, 3, 6, 4, 5, 7, 6. So, this is after sorting based on the least significant digit. Now, this is the digit by digit sort here. So, this is the next digit and we sort again this number based on this digit. And again we are using a stable sorting algorithm. Maybe we can use the counting sort. So, if you do that, then just look at the value, the digit. So, the 2 is the minimum. So, there are 2 2s. So, it should piece up the stability. So, these 2 should come first. So, 7 to 0, then we have these 2, 3 to 9, and then we have 3, but there are 2 3s. So, 4, 3, 6 should come first, then the 3, 6, 8, then we have no 4, we have 5, we have 3 5s, 1, 2, 3, and among this, this is first came first stability. So, then 4, 5, 7 and 6, 5, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay. So, now finally, most significant digit, and again here we are using the help of a counting sort or any stable sorting algorithm. So, if you do, then this is the minimum 3, and here also we need to piece up the ordering. So, this 3 should come first, 3 to 9, then this 3, 3, 5, 5, and then 4, there are 2 4s, this 4 should come, 4, 3, 6, and 4, 5, 7, and there are 6, 6, 5, 7, and there are 7, 7, 2, 0, and 8, 3, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, sorted. So, this is basically the radix sort. So, it is a digit by digit sort, and it starts from the least significant digit to the most significant digit. So, here digit are by decimal digit 0 to 9, this is the least significant digit. So, we sort this number based on this, and then we sort this number based on the next digit, and then we sort this number based on the next, which is the most significant digit. Okay. So, this is the shortest. Now, what is the correctness of this, why this is working? To know the correctness, we have to think of in terms of the induction method of induction way. Now, suppose we are assuming this algorithm is correct up to tth digit or t minus 1 digit. So, suppose t is say 2. So, suppose this algorithm is correct up to this. Now, we need to prove that this algorithm is correct after this tth digit to sort. Now, we are assuming this algorithm is correct up to this. Okay. Now, if there are 2 numbers different, like here say there are 3 and 4, if they are different, then 3 will come first, then 4, there is no issue. Only issue will come if there are common number, this 3 and this 3. So, among these 2 3, we know the algo is correct up to this. This is the assumption we made, this is the method of induction we are proving. We know the algo is correct up to t minus 1 steps. Okay. This is our assumption, and we are going to show this is correct after tth step. Now, if the algo is correct up to t minus 1 steps, then this will appear before this, because this value is less than this. Okay. Now, once this will appear before this, then this is a stable sorting algorithm we are using. So, these 3 must appear first, then these 3. Sorry, I miss a 3. Yeah, I sorry, the, yeah, these 3 must appear before, then these 3. So, this is the correctness. So, we assume that our algo is correct up to tth step, up to after second step it is okay. Now, we are going to show it is correct after up to t minus 1 step. Now, we are going to show it is correct after tth step. So, to do that, so we take, so between the different element we do not have no issue. Only problem is between the equal element. So, these 3 2 are equal. So, now we know this is correct up to this. So, that means this will come before than this. Okay. So, since it is coming before than this and we are using a stable sorting algorithm at the tth step. So, this must come before this, that is what is happening. So, this is correct. So, this is the correctness of this radix sort. Now, we talk about the time we have to analyze this radix sort. So, let us have a quick analysis of radix sort. Okay, so analysis of radix sort, and we will see that it is a linear time sorting algorithm, sorry, radix sort. Okay, so to analyze the radix sort, suppose there are n element, suppose there are n inputs, okay, and say each inputs are say b bits. So, each inputs are b bits. So, there are n numbers, each of these are binary bits. So, if we have given input, we convert into binary 0 1 bits. So, there are n numbers, okay. So, there are n numbers. So, each number is of total b bit. So, we have given a number, any number we convert into binary and the maximum size is b bits. Okay. Now, we have to fix our digit. Now, suppose we take our digit as say r bit. So, these are the numbers which are b bits number, n numbers, and now we fixed our digit by r bit. R could be any value, say 3. So, there are 3 bits we are using as a r. So, r bit is 1 digit. So, this is our, we are defining this, we are taking r bit as 1 digit and we divide this into digits. So, r bit, r bit, r bit, provided this b is multiple of r. Okay, so, these are our digits, dot 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 dot, like this. So, this is the r bit, this is r bit, this is least significant digit r bit. So, how many digits are there? So, number of, so each digit is r bit. So, number of digit will be b by r. Okay, this is the number of digit. Now, we are going to sort this digit by digit. So, this is the least significant digit, then this is next significant digit, like this. Now, we are going to sort digit by digit. So, we sort this first, this we sort this number based on this value, this is the least significant value of this. So, this is r bit. So, what is the maximum value it can, so how much time it will take. So, we if we are using counting sort, we know counting sort will take theta of n plus k. What is the k? K is the maximum range of that number. So, if it is r bit, the range is basically 2 to the power r. So, that means, if it is r bit, each can take one value. So, it is order of 2 to the power r. So, basically it is basically theta of n plus 2 to the power r. this is the time complexity to sort each of these digit. We sort this number based on this digit, and this is the time. So, total number of digit is this. So, that means time complexity for radix sort is runtime of radix sort is basically theta of how many digit, b by r digit, and each digit will take this much time, n plus 2 to the power r. So, this is the time complexity of radix sort, where b is the total number of bits in binary and n is the number of element to be sorted, and r is the size of our digit. We are defining that, we are fixing some size for our digit. Okay, so now how it is coming to be linear? So, let us just talk about that. Now, suppose we to choose r to be log n. Suppose we fix our digit size to be log n base 2, okay. Then 2 to the power r is basically n. So, then this will be basically theta of b n by r, r is again log n base 2, okay. So, now suppose we know, so our we know our numbers are coming from, our numbers are coming from this range 0 to n to the power d minus 1. Suppose our numbers are coming from this range, okay. So, this is the maximum value. So, this is the maximum value our number can take. So, we have n such numbers, each number can take this. Now, numbers are basically b bits, each number is b bits, binary bits. So, what is the maximum value? Yeah, it can take, so 2 to the power b minus 1. So, basically 2 to the power b is basically n to the power d. So, this means what? If you take the log, b is basically d log n base 2. So, b by d, b by log n is basically d. So, this is basically theta of d of n, theta of d of n. What is d? D is the, we have n numbers and we are assuming the numbers are coming from this range 0 to n to the power d minus 1. So, that case it is basically theta of d n. Now, if d is constant, just like if the numbers are coming say n to the power 100 minus 1, 0 to n to the power minus 1, then n to the power 10, d is 10. So, this is a constant. So, then this will be theta of n, if d is a constant. So, this is a linear time algorithm provided d is a constant, okay. So, bucket sort is a linear time sorting algorithm provided, I mean if the number we choose are from this range, okay. So, next we will talk about another sorting algorithm, which is basically this is radix sort, which is now we talk about bucket sort. So, for bucket sort we are having some, we have some numbers, and here we need to assume the numbers are coming uniformly from the interval 0 1 bucket sort. So, here we are assuming that the numbers are coming from the interval 0 and 1, this is open interval, this is closed interval. The elements are coming, the numbers are coming uniformly from this. Uniformly means we need to have this assumption in order to get the time complexity for this. So, what we do? So, we basically the idea is to, suppose there are n numbers, suppose n numbers. So, idea is to partition this into n sub intervals. We divide this into, divide the interval into n sub intervals. Okay, so numbers are n numbers are coming from this. Now we divide this into sub intervals, and each are called bucket. So this is a b0, b1, dot dot dot, bn minus 1. This is starting from 0. So these are called buckets. So this basically we have n buckets. Okay, b0 to bn sub intervals, they are denoting by b0, b1, bn minus 1, and these are basically bucket. Okay. And then we have this number, we put into the buckets depending on the value of this, and once we fill the bucket and we sort individual bucket and we report it, that is it. So let us write the code. So let us write the pseudo code for bucket sort. So there are n numbers, so which are giving in A array. So n is the length of this array. Okay, so what we do, for I is equal to 1 to n, we fill the bucket, do insert, we insert AI into the corresponding bucket, B of n of AI, lower ceiling. Okay, so this is the bucket filling. We will take an example, and then after that, once we have the buckets of numbers, then we sort this each bucket. For there are n buckets, for I is equal to 1 to, sorry, this will be 0 to n minus 1, yes, 0 to n minus 1, because bucket is starting from b0 to bn. Sorting means we use the insertion sort basically, insertion sorting algorithm. We sort this bi, we sort each bucket contains some numbers, we sort it, and then we concatenate just the bucket after sorting. We concatenate this b0, then b1, concatenate this bn minus 1, and this will give us a sorted one. Okay. So let us take an example, quick example. Suppose our n is 10 and the numbers are basically, say, suppose n is 10 and suppose numbers are like this 0.78, 0.17, 0.39, 0.26, 0.72. So we are assuming these numbers are coming from uniformly from this interval 0, 1, 0.94, 0.21, 0.12, 0.23, and then 0.68. How many numbers? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay. So we want to sort this into the buckets. So here n is 10. So we have buckets like 0 to 10. So these are the buckets basically. So we have 0 bucket, so 1, 2 up to 9. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, then 9. We divide into equal. So now we put into the bucket. So one bucket means the points 1. So points 1 is basically we have 0.12, and then we have 0.17, 0.12, and we have 0.17, and then we have 0.2 bucket is basically we are putting into this like this. So, but it is a basically a linked list, 0.21 and then 0.23 and 0.26, and then number 3 we have only one element, 0.39. These are the bucket, and 6 we have only 1.68, and 7 we have two elements, 0.72,
0.78,
and then we have 9, we have 0.94. Okay, so this is the bucket filling, then after that we sort this using the insertion sort, individual bucket. So these are the number falling in the bucket number 2, B2, then we sort these numbers using the insertion sort. And then we just print the buckets, like concatenate the bucket. So this is basically bucket sort. Now what is the time complexity for this bucket sort? Time is basically, so we are reading all the elements and we are filling into the bucket, so that will take the theta in time, and then we are, after bucket filling, we are sorting the individual buckets using insertion sort, so that will take the time depending on the number of element in the ith bucket. So if the number of element in the ith bucket is n, then this is basically summation of ni theta of ni square, I is equal to 0 to n minus 1, where ni is the number of elements fall in the in bi, ith bucket, because each bucket is sorted by using the insertion sort. So this is the time. Now if we take the expected value of this, then this is basically expectation of this. So this is basically theta of n plus summation of, we can take big O here. So big O of, so summation of big O of expected value of ni square. So I is from 0 to n minus 1. Okay. Now this expected value of ni square, we can prove that this is to be, so okay, so the time complexity is basically expected time complexity is basically run time is theta of n plus summation of big O of expectation of ni square, and this I is from 0 to n minus 1. Now we claim that this expectation of ni square, we have to prove this, is basically 1 2 minus 1 by n. If we can prove this, then this is basically, suppose this is, this yet to prove, suppose we assume this is okay for all I, then this will become what, then this will become expected, this will become linear. So how to prove this? Expected value of ni square is 2 minus this. So to prove this, we need to take help of indicator random variable. So this we have to prove. So what is that? Now we define xij is 1 if aj falls in j ith bucket, if aj falls in ith bucket, 0 otherwise. Xij is 1 if aj is falls in, because this ball, this elements are chosen randomly from 0 1. Okay, and we have n buckets, b0 to bn minus 1. So we define this. So what is ni? Ni is basically summation of xi. So ni is the number of element in ith bucket. So ni is basically summation of xi, and this I is where j is varying from 1 to n. So we take the expectation of ni square. So ni square is basically this square, and we take the expectation of this. So this will basically the expected value of, expectation is a linear function, we will take that xi square x I j square plus summation of, double summation of x I k x k j, x I j I k, where k not equal to j. This is the form of square. Now expectation is a linear function, we take the expectation inside. So this is basically summation, this is summation. So we take the expectation inside. So expectation of x I x j square, and this j is from 1 to n plus this summation of expectation of these two, and this is a independent. So, this anyway, let us write this, and this is k not equal to j. Okay, so if we write this, then this is basically, now this term is basically expectation of x I square is how much? X I x j square is basically 1 into 1 by n plus 0 is to 1 minus 1 by n. So, this is basically 1 by n, and now this will give us expectation of x I j, x I k, if we take the independentness of these two, into expectation of x I k. So, this will give us basically 1 by n square. So, if we plug this value over here, we are getting basically n into 1 by n plus n into n minus 1 into 1 by n square. So, this will give us basically 2 minus 1 by n, that is what we are looking for, 2 minus 1 by n. So, that is basically expectation of n I square. So, if we put this expectation there, we are getting basically bucket sort is linear. Thank you.